Assalamu alaikum, how are you guys? Well, there have been some days I have not created a video. Actually, I was busy for some days, so today I came with a new pen testing video. I think this one is going to be my first ever pen testing video on YouTube. So it's actually SSH exploit. If you don't know what SSH is, SSH is secure shell, an encrypted shell. Most system have this by default, and no matter if they are Windows or Linux, it can be installed there. So mostly system administrator use it to connect to some machine, some host, and some power users also who rent some VPS, some machines in cloud, and they connect to it using SSH. It is very secure, but it has some exploits which today I am going to show you. Actually, I am going to exploit it on a Manjaro virtual machine. It is a latest Manjaro ISO file which I just created a virtual machine in virtual box. So I am going to exploit this one. So SSH has some brute force attack can be launched against it and something, but before doing something I would recommend you these settings. So if you enable these settings, there are chances that you will not be get hacked. Well, SSH usage, /etc/ssh-d_config. This is the system-wide SSH configuration. So let's open it, and here you can see the first thing I commented it here. Actually I edited, don't actually now I don't understand if what was the default value here, but I changed it to without password. Well, that means that the root user or the administrator account on this system can't log in to this system using SSH if they don't provide a key, an SSH public key. Public and private, actually public key need to be in this remote host, and if the public key, I will tell you about the location of that key file. But if that public key is added to this system, root user only that way can log in to this system. Else, even if you have root password, you can't log in to this system using SSH. And you can do public authentication, yes. So here are the keys. The public key file path. So you can actually edit this line, and whatever you put it here, that will be counted at that public key path. So the H, this percentage sign and H, this relates to the every Linux user home directory. So it should be like cd and this one. So it should be ssh and authorized keys. So that's it. This one is the key path, authorized keys. Here I have added an other key which I also consider as an authorized key. Actually I wrote a script which you can find on my GitHub. If you use that and you allow some super key, like with that key you can log into any user that exists on the remote system. So that's not the topic for today. So, and other things to consider, this thing, password authentication, you should disable it. Like you should comment this line on your system and change yes to no. So if this is no, you can't use password to log into this system. And here is what this comment is saying. Also permit empty password, we don't permit empty password. So consider this password authentication is no. Password authentication is no. Yeah, well, so keep that those things I have mentioned in mind. That's actually the solution to this exploit, what I am going to explain and do a practical in this video session. So now let's start with it. Here is the machine, our victim machine. So I am going to check the IP. This one is the IP of this machine. So just check if SSH is already open on this system. You can see it is inactive. And so let's enable SSH, and with now flag, the most recent system diversions have enabled the now dash dash now, which if you use with enable or disable, so it also stops that service. If you do disable and if you do enable, it just enable that service on the next boot. But if you use dash dash now, it will enable that service at boot time, as well as it will start that service as well right now. So here now you can check that the here you can see SSH is running on this system. So this one is a new machine with default credentials. I have not changed the password, I have not changed the username, there is no other username. I think root nobody, I think there is no other user, like normal user. Yeah, this one is, there is no 11001. Yeah, that's it. This one is the only user on this system. So now the SSH is running on our victim machine. So now go to the machine, our host, and open a metasploit. It will take some time. So now it has been open. If you have some system you want to record or you want to track the access, you can start the PostgreSQL database, because Metasploit use that database. So I'm not going to do that, but you can always do like sudo systemctl enable and now postgresql or something like that. So I am not going to start it right now because I don't need it. So I am going to use auxiliary and scanner ssh and ssh login. This one is we are going to use. So show options for an option. So blank password, actually this is by default, it is false. If you use this one, it will try the blank password. Brute force speed, this one is the speed for the brute force. Actually what we are going to do, we are going to do a brute force attack on our this Manjaro machine, which is here. So we are going to do a brute force password attack on SSH. So db all credentials, each credential which is in the database, should we use? No, it is also false by default. And these are all the settings. So which are the required, we here they are listed. So this one is required, it is already, it is set here. So I think that's okay. And what else is required? This one, our host, you can see it is not set here. You can see there is no set, no string there for this value. So let's set it, set our host, and give it the IP of our victim. In this case our victim IP is 104 192.168.1.104. what else? Port is already defined. If the system, if the victim is running on a non-standard port, you can use that port, like if the system is our port and something blah 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 blah, you can configure SSH to use some other port using that SSH config, which I already have configured. So no need to set it. And stop on success, it is false. I have only one victim, so I don't think that I need it. And threads one, it is also required, one thread is enough. Username no, and user pass file is not there. And verbose is false. So let me do verbose true. So what it will do, it will tell us about every password attempt, if it was okay or if it was failed. Actually, only on the failed attempt it will show you. Once we get success, we can see the shell and more messages there. Also, we can configure this value here. So now what else we need? We need a user pass file or something like that, because we want to do brute force attack. So let's create a password attack here. Pwd, it is the our current working directory. Keep that in mind where you save your password file, password list, password and user list. Actually, we are going to use. So we are going to create a password list, password and users dot list. So the first password is root and default pass. The first one is the user with the space and then the password. The password we are going to use first for root and then user root and password tour, the default Kali login for the previous releases. I don't know if it has changed since I am using Arch Linux, so I don't have an idea. Then we have Manjaro user here. Give it some random password, some password, Manjaro user, some password, and Manjaro. Manjaro and new password, that's it. So here we have created our password and user list, so we are going to use it. Just check it, the directory where it is, and this one is the name of that file name. So set user pass file, set user pass file, and then give it to path of that new file 370250. Yeah, and the password user list, that's it. So now we are going to use that exploit. So just run exploit or run. You can see the first one is failed, the second one is failed, the third one also failed. Here you can see that the Manjaro some password is failed, Manjaro some password is failed, Manjaro a user and the Manjaro password. You can see we have got success and we have got a shell. Here we can check the sessions and L. Here you can see we have a shell Linux. So sessions, interactively we want to use this shell, the first one, the ID. So ID, here you can see I am logged in as Manjaro. If you can check if this user has the sudo access. If that has the sudo access, then we have got the root access. So just do sudo su and now check. Here you can see we have got the root access. So that's it guys. we are going to exit, and that's it. So that was the exploit on SSH. I hope you guys like this video. If you have any question, just put them in the comment section. Subscribe to my YouTube channel if you have not done so. Let's meet in a new video. Thanks for watching. Bye.